The title for my offertory today is Goals in This Life. The question I have is, can we have goals and dreams in this life? Should we pursue them? Should we hope for them? I used to be afraid of setting goals. I was always scared that this world was ending, and the thought was, well, what's the point really in setting goals? What's the point in chasing after them? I've come to realize since then that it's a seriously foolish way to think. The major goal, of course, as a Christian, is to enter into the kingdom of God. We should know this scripture by heart, Matthew 6 and verse 33, which says, "But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." So how do we incorporate this? How do we break down this major goal given to us? Do we know that we should be doing this? It's a rather massive goal. It's easy to get lost in this all-encompassing goal. So it's something that we have to meditate on. As you know, today is the Feast of Trumpets. This day pictures the return of Jesus Christ to this earth to break the rule of Satan and to institute a new way, the new kingdom. Brethren, how aware are we of what this day will mean? I'm sure we're going to hear more about that. But how long has it been since we've studied what that is going to be picturing? What's going to be happening at this time when Christ is returning? How do we see ourselves living through this coming time? What are we doing to prepare? A lot of questions. You know, the seduction of life is to just let it flow by. It's so easy to do. You know, you can wake up 5 years down the road and you can have nothing to show for it. The Bible speaks of five foolish virgins who woke up. They realized they needed the Holy Spirit to get them through the darkness that was there. But it was too late. They lost out. They wandered off trying to go find it. So, brethren, the question then is, what are you, what am I doing? What are you doing today? What have you done today? What about tomorrow? What about the next day? You know, if we have any goals or aspirations in this life, we know that it takes focus, daily attention to those things that we are striving for. It takes working on our habits when we are seeking change. If we don't put this type of dedicated focus on those things which we want, then we will have nothing to show for it. You know, we can easily fool ourselves into believing that we are busy and so we are accomplishing things. But what we cannot do is to confuse busyness with being productive. It's easy to fool ourselves into believing that we are so busy that we cannot or do not have the time to do this or that. Brethren, the truth is that we do have time. We have everything we need. It just depends how badly we want that thing that we are going after and how we prioritize. I'd like to read John 15 and verse 16. I think we heard this scripture. John 15 and verse 16 says, "You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you might go and bear fruit. Fruit that will last, so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you." We see God's choice here. As we heard this morning, God chose you and I individually. He handpicked us, and he wants us to go and bear fruit. So we can have goals. And we can expect that if they are in line with God and what he is, his will, they will come to fruition. But if we are not first and foremost focused on growing our Christian fruits, then we will not get that which we desire. And why should we? You know, if God is not the first and foremost focus for us, then what's the point? Colossians 1 and verse 10 says, "So that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work and growing in the knowledge of God." So how's that going for us? Do we feel that we are growing? Do we feel close to God? Or are we fooling ourselves like those virgins who are sleeping, thinking that we are okay? Well, no one knows the answer except for yourself. Each of us knows that answer if we are willing to look at the truth and deal with it. In Malachi 3 and verse 10, God tells us to bring the tithe into his house. It says, "Bring all the tithes into the storehouse that there may be food in my house. And now try me now in this, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessing that there will not be room enough to receive it." So the command is to pay our tithes, and that includes also our offerings. We are individually a part of God's house. We are being built up. 1 Peter 2 and verse 5 says, "You also, as living stones, are being built up as a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ." And again in Ephesians 2 and verse 22, "In whom you are also being brought together for a dwelling place of God in the Spirit." Brethren, while we bring an offering today, and it's commanded and it's important, God deems our willingness to stretch and to grow daily while keeping him at the forefront of all we do. In our thoughts, it has to be of the utmost value. So let's continue to choose each day to be a dwelling place for the Spirit of God and to have goals and aspirations so that we can grow as God wants us to.